the Minister for Infrastructure, Transport, Usamate, and we also acknowledge. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your.
Oh, it's amazing. This is a miracle in itself.
It's really great to see all of the organizations that are here, the military forces, all of the stakeholders that are in this very important industry that we have, the maritime sector, teachers and students. It's great to see the students, great to see the young female naval officers that are here, great to see the students also from the Maritime Academy, and also all those from the private sector and also government institutions, government bodies that have a part to play in the important workings of the maritime sector. I'm pleased to be with you this morning to celebrate the World Maritime Day for 2019. World Maritime Day is a special day. It's a special day because we focus our attention to appreciating the contributions made by the maritime industry to improve our lives. It is a day in which we reflect on the supply chain, the benefit we derive from efficient shipping services that has contributed greatly to building our national economies, our lives, the lives of our people, and making our world more accessible over time. As I was just sitting here listening to the pastor talking, I was thinking about this particular sector being something like, you know, like our whole bodies, our bodies that we have. We eat food, it's processed in our body, then the goodness, all the glucose and all these things is transported all over the body. If we did not have that transportation system, the transfer that moves the glucose and moves oxygen from the way that we begin, if it's not moved right across the whole body collapses. And that's the same way with life that we have right now. A few hundred years ago, we lived on our own islands and we could survive what we had on our islands. But today, the whole world is interconnected. And to keep that world going, to keep our country going, to keep the global economy going, we need to have these transportation services. So sometimes we disregard it, we don't see it as important. But today is a great day because we recognize the importance of this sector. It basically is the blood system, the system of transport, like just like we have in our own bodies. It's the things that keeps everything moving in our country, in our economy, and especially in our region, where we have to depend on things that are bought from other countries to maintain and sustain life in our own country. So the International Maritime Organization has declared this year's theme. I can see one of the banners that was here had the theme, Empowering Women in the Maritime Community. And this is something that's being celebrated all over the world. Empowering women is not just an idea or concept. It is a necessity. It's something that's absolute necessary. And it requires strong action. It requires positive action to address a lot of things that are deep-seated structural impediments, institutional impediments, and cultural barriers that have stopped women from becoming as heavily involved in this sector. So it has become a necessity to do this. Throughout history, the maritime sector, especially in shipping, has been a male-dominated industry. IMO, the International Maritime Organization, through its gender and capacity building program, has been making an effort, a very concerted effort, a strong effort, to help move the industry forward and help women achieve better representation in this key sector, keeping up with our 21st century expectations. In placing the human element and capacity building high on its agenda, the International Maritime Organization recognizes that the shipping industry, the maritime sector, must reach out to every sector of the community if it is to attract the very best people to pursue a maritime career. As a specialized agency of the United Nations, the IMO has a strong commitment to helping the achievement of our sustainable development goals. And it continues to support the participation of women in both shore-based and seagoing posts, in line with the goals outlined under SDG 5, to achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. This year's theme gives all member states and United Nations organizations, including the IMO, a unique opportunity to work with various maritime stakeholders towards achieving SDG 5. The notion that shipping has always been a male-dominated industry has changed, and it must change, and it must continue to change. Gender equality is now being recognized as one of the key platforms on which people can build a sustainable future. It is one of the 17 goals that underpins the United Nations Sustainable Development Agenda, which countries all over the world have pledged to implement. Fiji, as a member state and a hub of the seafaring industry in the Pacific, is moving towards sustainability and supporting the empowerment of women, defying the traditional ways we have tended to look at the role of women. There are now an increasing number of women at sea. Barriers that have limited their participation in different aspects of our national life are being broken down. And over the past decade, we have seen a rise in women, full and meaningful participation in the economy, political decision-making, education, and I was just reading the papers this week. I think more of our graduates coming out of our universities now, there are more women than females. You better watch out, boys. Education, the world of work and society. The maritime sector is a sector where the need to eliminate gender inequality has often been overlooked. Last week, I attended the 4th Pacific Regional Energy and Transport Ministers meeting in Samoa with ministers and officials from throughout the Pacific region to deliberate on the theme, sustainable energy and transport services for the Blue Pacific. At that meeting, climate change was reaffirmed as the single greatest threat to the livelihoods, security, and well-being of the people of the Pacific. And that theme has been a theme that has been coming to us from the United Nations General Assembly this week, where our Prime Minister has been speaking about the importance of climate change and the impact it has on the lives of the current generation of Pacific Islanders like you and me and those that will follow us tomorrow. The meeting also emphasized the importance of the energy and transport sectors in reducing greenhouse gas emissions and protecting our oceans. And this is also has to be an area that the maritime sector, the shipping sector, will have to look at this area. How can they contribute also to greenhouse gas emission reduction? Because if we don't do that, it's going to have an impact on our generations that will follow us in the Pacific. Our Pacific is the world's largest ocean, covering nearly one-third of the Earth's surface. One-third of the Earth's surface, Donekatolu, of the whole world, is covered by the Pacific Ocean. It contains about 30,000 islands of various shapes and sizes. One of the big problems that we now have around the world is the intrusion of plastic into this ocean. Plastic intrusion into the ocean. And other materials means that every beach in all these 30,000 islands is now beginning to be littered with rubbish caused by mankind. The impact of rubbish extends further, adversely affecting the health of the people of the Pacific, the oceans and the estuaries, the fisheries where our fish, our source of life, source of food, our coral reefs, our shellfish, our seabirds, and marine biodiversity generally. For me, it was interesting to note that an estimated 8 million tons of plastic. Think of 8 million tons of plastic? I wonder if we put 8 million tons of plastic in the sewer. It might cover the whole of sewer and more. 8 million tons of plastic is disposed in the marine environment annually. Not over 100 years or 50 years, 1 year. That's the number of plastic we are putting into the ocean. And all this plastic that is going into the ocean, the Pacific only contributes 1%. So in the Pacific, we put very little amount of plastic relative to the others. A study that was undertaken by SPREP, which is the South Pacific Regional Environment Program, on fish ingestion. That means how fish are taking the plastic into themselves, how they are ingesting the microplastics. They had samples from Fiji, New Zealand, Samoa, and Rapa Nui. You know where Rapa Nui is? Anybody know where Rapa Nui is? Geography? Easter Island, eh? Good. Easter Island. You heard of Easter Island? Those big rock statues there? That's Easter Island, Rapa Nui. So they took the samples from Fiji, New Zealand, Samoa, and Rapa Nui, showed that, listen to this, showed that in this area, 97% of all fish samples had microplastics. 97%. That means the fish that we are buying, I know that USP did some study of fish that are caught across the bay here. Those fish are beginning to have plastics in them. You buy the fish, what happens to that plastic? Where does it go? It goes inside of you. Can you get that? The fish that we are getting now, this is the danger of not making sure that we look after the plastic that's getting out into the ocean. And the percentage of plastic that is shown in Fiji, New Zealand, Samoa and Rapuni was 30% higher than the global average. The meeting in Samoa also emphasized on the importance of safety over everything else. Safety is paramount, especially for people that are sailing on ships, and the application of the International Convention for the Safety of Life at Sea, or SOLAS, Chapter 5, in regards to navigational, and meteorological warning, search and rescue, hydrography, ship reporting, routing systems, vessel traffic systems, and aids to navigation. Gender equality was also an important agenda in last week's meeting, in which empowering women in the maritime sector was a very topical issue. Ministers from the region endorsed the regional strategy for women in maritime for the years 20 to 24. And I have to congratulate our women in maritime that I can see that are here for their pushing for this and getting that regional strategy in place. They have committed to implement priority actions of the strategy, such as collecting reliable and accurate data through national and regional networks, including information on women employed in the Pacific maritime sector. I've noticed that the sector has basically three pillars. It talks about recognizing the leadership and contribution of women in this sector. It talks about giving more visibility to women in the sector. And I think we're doing a good job here in Fiji, because I see, is it a monthly or fortnightly thing that you have this? This is a highlight in the papers about the importance of women. And third, capacity building of women in the maritime sector. Those are going to be the three pillars of that strategy. We must support our women to grow our maritime networks, to conduct in-country promotion and conduct visibility campaigns in schools and communities. There is no limit, I believe, to what women can do. Fiji needs women in the maritime community to take this message seriously, and I therefore wish to re-echo the theme that we have for today's, for the 2019 World Maritime Day theme of empowering women in the maritime community. The sector needs all hands on deck, both male and female. Translating this into action requires bold and forward-thinking maritime administrations, men and women that are prepared to break our socio-cultural silos. More women on board will go a long way to solving challenges faced by the maritime industry, especially any perceived shortage of skilled seafarers. Globally, it has been reported and estimated that the number of marine officers have increased by 34% between 2005 and 2010. And it is now estimated to have increased by 24% in the past 5 years. The global percentage of women in the maritime industry sits at 2%. Empowering women fuels thriving economies across nations. It spurs growth and development and benefits all of us working in the maritime community as we strive towards a safe, a secure, a clean and sustainable shipping. On that note, let me thank you all for coming this morning. Let me thank all the stakeholders. Let me welcome you all and wish you a successful World Maritime Day. Thank you, Minawale, and Bahut Danyabad.